Hello everyone, welcome to the ETAPS tutorial series. Today we learn how to solve these three basic simple spotted problem by ETAP and verify the result. Okay, let's start first this simple spotted beam with UDL and a point load. Okay, in this beam, first thing you have to note is a single beam, not two beams. It is a single beam of 9 meter. And A is roller support and C is pin support, and the dimensions of this beam is not given, so we consider, and the material is also not given, so we consider the material and dimensions. So this is ETAP, go to new model, and select metric SI unit, Indian, steel code and RCC code. Okay, if this is grid system, and in my problem we have a 9 meter beam, so we need a 9 meter spacing in grid, so only I have to change here 9 meter. 9 meter and OK. So first step is grid define, the second step is material, and the third step is cross section define, and the cross section and material is not given, so we consider default. So we directly draw a beam through this draw icon and select here default concrete beam, CONCEBM, concrete beam, and click here to here. Okay, 9 meter beam created. Now this joint is roller support, assign joint, restrain and roller. And the next joint is pin support, select joint, go to assign joint, restrain and pin support. The next step, load, select, before you have to apply load, you have to select the member and go to assign frame loads, and we have two loads, a point load at 6 meter distance and UDL at 0 to 6 meter. Okay, so select frame, assign frame load, distributed load, and select absolute distance. What is the difference between this relative distance and absolute distance, and what is this uniform load? If you put value here, the load apply to the whole beam. Okay, if you select relative distance, it means if you have to apply load at the center, it means the proportion of the center of the beam is 0.5. We have to distance, put here 0.5 and the load value. Okay, if you select absolute distance, you have select distance and then apply load. Like we have to apply a UDL 0 to 6 meter, start from first point 0 meter and end at 6 meter. So 0 at distance 0, the load is, load intensity is 1.5. At distance 6 meter, sorry, select here. Okay, at 0 distance load is 1.5, at 6 meter load is 1.5. And click OK. Now you check here the something wrong in the load. So what we do, go, let's select the beam and frame load and UDL and check. Okay, here value is not changed, 6 meter. Now the load is correct. The next is point load at 6 meter, select the beam, assign frame load, point load, same as select absolute, 6 meter and the intensity of load is 3 kilonewton. Okay, and done. You can see here by zoom out, zoom in, 1.5 is UDL and this. Then analysis. It's simple. In this beam tutorial, you learn how to apply loads. After analysis, check bending my diagram and right click on the beam. Now you can see clearly. This is loading diagram, shear force diagram, bending moment diagram and deflection diagram. Done. The next problem is this. In this problem you can see here is the two reaction. It means the support is pin. Here one reaction is means support is roller, is free end and the vertical load is applied. Okay, how many beams? One beam and two beam. We count beam support to support. Okay, so A to B one beam and B to D second beam, and the first beam distance 6 meter and second beam is 4 meter. So again go to new model. So now we have a grid of 6 meter and 4 meter. So go to the custom grid, edit, and here change 8 to 6 and 16 to 10, 6 plus 4, 10, and OK and OK. Now you can see here we have 6 meter spacing and 4 meter. Again the property is not given. So we select draw beam, properties concrete beam default, and select and select. Okay. In this problem, one more new thing you learned. So please watch this, not the same as the previous. In this beam you learn a new thing. Okay, first support is pin support, assign, joint, restrain, pin, and the second support is roller support, and the last support is free. Check loads. Okay, in first beam load is starting from 2 meter and end at 6 meter. So select the beam, assign frame load, distributed intensity of load is 5. Okay, start it at 2 meter and finish at 6 meter and intensity is 5, like that. Okay, the point load is 25 kilonewton at the free end. So select joint, assign joint load, force in Z direction minus for downward 25 and OK. Now verify the result. These are the shear force and bending moment diagram. Check the result analysis. After analysis, show the bending moment diagram, but not to check here. Right click on the beam, check here. This is the shear force diagram of first beam. In first beam, you can see here the shear force diagram is different from the E tab. So let's check the load condition. Okay, pin support, roller support, 25 kilonewton. Okay, one more thing. In this problem the self weight is not considered, so we have to zero self weight. So select unlock this button and select your both beam and go to the assign frame property modifier, and self weight means mass and weight convert into zero. Now PM is property modifier, then again analysis. Now the result is only due to the external load. Again check bending moment diagram and shear force diagram by not on the screen. Right click on the beam. Now the shear force diagram is correct, same as the problem. And bending moment diagram is also correct. If you check, bending moment diagram is like a parabolic, but because this is made by a human, he straight line then parabolic, but in graphical view we can't change this, we can't see by eye, because you can see this is the straight and this parabolic. You can check the value. Here value is 20. At 2 meter value bending moment is 20. So at 2 meter how you can you check? You put value here 2 meter and check bending moment is 20. You can see here we change the value 2 meter and the bending moment at 2 meter is 20. It means the result is verified. Like that you have to learn ETAP by verify problems. Okay. Check next problem. Okay, next problem is not I am doing. Next problem is for you. Please note this diagram. I give you hint in the first load. I give you hint for this problem. You have to try by self. In first problem is a UVL, uniform varying load. You consider this is a UDL when you apply load. In UDL case, we apply at zero distance load is zero and at distance 6 meter load is 10. Automatically UVL created. If here we put 10, then this is uniform distributed load. If zero at zero distance you put zero load, it's convert to UVL. Okay, and this UDL you also known as. Now the movement, when you apply point load, you change the movement and apply easily. And if you don't, you have any problem and any this problem, please comment, then I solve your problem. Please try yourself this problem. Thank you very much.